You've got £50 in your account in the pro shop at your golf club. You're buying Pro V1s or you're buying AVX. Titleist new golf balls, same price as Pro V1s, but who are they aimed at? Let's find out. Let's talk technology on the AVXs from Titleist. I'm just going to read the back of the box. So first up, we've got a new larger core. So that's a step up from last time's AVX. This is the difference. It's a formulation which generates higher ball speeds and lower long game spin. So you're going to hit the ball further because of that core. They've then got the unique aerodynamic dimples, which we're seeing on the Pro V1s. It's a painted design. That's why they look like a Pro V1. And that's going to deliver more consistency through the air. Next up is a new thinner cast urethane elastomer cover system, which provides, once again, greater ball speed and still a lot of spin and control around the green. So keep saying you are going to get the best of both worlds with this ball. And then finally, they've redesigned a high flex casing layer to promote, guess what? Once again, higher ball speeds and lower spinning shots on long irons. So you're going to hit bombs, but you're still going to be able to chip and get it close to the flag, apparently. So these golf balls are supposed to be lower spinning and you'll still get the feel around the greens. Now I've taken them out of the packet, look like a Pro V. Writing's the same, cover looks the same actually with the dimples as well, but it's the core that's different in these AVXs. I've got to say, I didn't think there was a ball that Titleist produced, which is the same price as a Pro V1. I thought that was their ultimate golf ball. That was their highest priced golf ball and everything else came below it. What I'm gonna do is compare them against the Pro Vs in data and feel. Well, I wouldn't say that wasn't a Pro V actually with this 6-iron. Looks like one, feels actually soft. Okay, we've got a baseline. Let's have a go with the Pro Vs. So the AVXs are supposed to feel softer, fly lower and spin less than the Pro V1 when hitting a longer iron, an iron or even a driver actually. So I'm going to hit some 6-irons with the Pro V1. I think the softness in the AVX has brought the ball speed down. It's definitely quicker with the Pro V, a couple of mile an hour quicker. We're going to work our way from the top of the bag to the bottom of the bag because the Titleist AVXs are saying that you're going to gain in that long game because you're going to have lower flight, lower spin, it's going to go further, but you're still going to keep that spin around your wedges. Can you have the best of both worlds? So I'm going to try and do my best to find that inside here at Mercedes-Benz Stockport. Moving on to the AVX. Now I've hit those Pro Vs pretty low spinning, so interesting to see what happens here. Gonna finish with a few wedges because Titleist is saying that you shouldn't see much difference when you start getting down to the more lofted clubs. You're not gonna be sacrificing any spin with a pitching wedge or even short game as well. It's finishing up with the Pro Vs. So just look at spin rate, AVXs were over 9,000 and the height was around 71 feet. Yeah, this feels higher off the face with the Pro V1. Need to look at those numbers. It feels like it launched higher off this wedge. more variation on the Pro V. Probably not in a good way. Okay, I've had quite a lot of hits actually. Driver, 6-iron, pitching wedge. Now look at the data and see if the claims that Titleist make are correct with my numbers, and try and work out who this golf ball is aimed at. Remember, it's very premium in price. Titleist are talking about this AVX ball being a lower flighted ball than a Pro V1, a lower spinning in the long game, but it's going to keep up in the short game. I was thinking, lower spinning than the Pro V1? I spin that really low and launch it low. I actually didn't want that. And these data hasn't suggested that that is the case. The one thing that I would definitely say is right of what Titleist has said is it does feel softer. Can 100% say that indoor testing. In terms of spin, it actually span a bit more, which I don't think is a terrible thing. It kept up in the pitching wedge to the point where it was actually spinning at another 400 RPM spin rate average up. So it was up with Pro V1 and outspinning it. But it did outspin it in other areas as well. Driver's pretty the same, pretty stable, like low 2000s. And we get to the 6-iron. I was in the 5000s RPM, where I was not in the 5000s RPM for the Pro V1. So a bit inconclusive at the moment. However, I still don't think it's a bad thing that it doesn't spin as low as a Pro V1, because I just dip them out of the sky. So yeah, a bit inconclusive, other than the fact that it did feel softer. Well, let's head outside and see if I can find a bit of a difference playing off some grass. Welcome to Prestbury. Some real-time testing now for the AVX. Going to play a few holes, different scenarios. I'm keen to see how the ball reacts on short game and putting, because for me, that's where I really want my ball to perform. It's all right it going a million miles, but do I get that feel around the greens? So first tee, driver, as I say, going to play a few and see how the AVX performs. I thought that was going to come off firmer, because obviously I keep saying low spin, but it didn't. So I'm just going to try and be a bit more aggressive with this. Remember, we're trying to get the best of both worlds, soft around the greens and fast off the face with the long stuff. Got a very similar alignment aid as what you'd find on the Pro V1s. Obviously it's got AVX, which means alternative to V and X. So it's still classing this ball as that high quality ball. See that in the price as well. Oh, never moved. Now I've compared the balls inside, and now I'm going to do a comparison outside, play a hole. But if you look at the two of them, there was a question mark over last time's AVX, of it not being looking quite as premium, the finish was a bit different. I don't think that's the case. It actually looks whiter than the Pro V one. And yeah, I'd say that's a more duller black on the Pro V one. But you would not say that this AVX does not look premium, which was a criticism of last time round. So let's see how they perform, especially into the wind, especially lower spinning. So I'm going to play the third hole at Prestbury and see how they go. Oh, get down. Certainly a height difference. AVX is coming out lower on all situations, driver and even off a downslope. Pro V1 flighted higher. Didn't find that inside. Now you might be thinking, at this price range, with less spin in the long game, more spin, or as much spin in the short game. Why would we not see this golf ball on tour and expect the likes of Justin Thomas to be putting it in the golf bag? Well, Pro V is such a well-marketed brand for Titleist that they want that in the best players' hands. That is on all the adverts. That's their number one ball, and that's what all the best players in the world use. I'm just trying to work out who I'm thinking these balls are aimed at. Somebody that spins it far too much with their long clubs. Maybe if you're playing the wind. It's definitely flighted down, wasn't it? I kept stressing inside how I wanted to know what the ball reacts in and around the green. So I'm going to set up a few scenarios just to help me with my verdict on this golf ball. The new Titleist AVX golf ball, is it an improvement on last time round? Yes, it is. Looks better, does have a bit better feel. It's a premium golf ball. And what I struggle with Titleist is when they don't call it Pro V1, I just don't think they're premium. And I think everyone has that. We're just so heavily marketed towards Pro V1, Pro V1, Pro V1. And I actually think if this was called Pro V1, Y or something like that, or Pro V1X dash, it would sell more. Indoor testing was a little bit inconclusive. Outdoor, I did feel like the ball flew lower with the longer shots when I took a head-to-head, especially into the wind. It really helped with that flight, so it did flight down the longer stuff. Around the green, I got a bit more control from a Pro V1. This ball is closer to the Pro V1 rather than the Pro V1X. So remember, that's kind of like the next one down in terms of spin. Off the face, it feels good. Like there's not a whole lot of difference. There really isn't a whole lot of difference, hence why the price is so close. It's going to be a minority of golfer. Titleist say the Pro V1 fits most golfers. And then you're going to go to extreme. So they brought the Pro V1 dash out for that extreme. And then they've got this extreme as well, which is a lower spinning golf ball. I don't think it'll sell great because I don't think it's marketed as well as a Pro V1. But there is an option for players out there. You play links golf in the wind, for instance, right now. This could be for you. But yes, it's an improvement on last time's AVX. It does look better. It is premium. But it's not a Pro V1. And I am just a Pro V1 convert, all that marketing. And I think many of us are. That was the Titleist AVX video. If you want to read the written review, check it out on golfalot.com. Thanks very much for watching. Make sure you like this video, comment below what golf ball are you playing, and I'll see you all again next time.